How do we classify variables in terms of discrete and continuous? Please note that these classifications are for quantitative variables only. They do not apply to qualitative variables, which are neither discrete or continuous in nature. Once we are certain a variable is quantitative, it can be classified as either discrete or continuous. Let's take a look at the difference. First off, assume I ask you the question, how old are you? Most of you, by default, will probably give your age in years. I am 35 years old. I'm 42. I'm 61. I'm 9. However, that's not actually a 100% accurate measurement of your age. In reality, we could measure down to a more precise level of accuracy. For example, I was born on March 27, 1981 at 6:21 a.m. Therefore, at the time of this recording, I was 35 years, 5 months, 26 days, 7 hours, 15 minutes. You get the idea. The level of accuracy can continue on forever. This is known as a continuous variable. A continuous variable continues on and on and on in terms of measurement accuracy. As a result, we say it can take on an infinite number of values. You can continue to add levels of measurement down to minutes, seconds, tenths, hundredths, and so on levels of measurement. Ask yourself, did I have to round this value for practical reasons? If the answer is yes, then the variable is continuous. In contrast, consider a question like this. How many dogs do I have? There they are. There are 3 of them. In case you care, they are Banjo, Seneca, and Abby, listed from left to right. There's no need to round the number of dogs I have. There are 3 distinct dogs. These variables can only take on a distinct countable number of options. Therefore, they are called discrete. There are only a few discrete options. Now, one common misconception relates to decimals. Many assume that any variable or any value presented with a decimal must be continuous, while any value without a decimal is discrete. But consider something like shoe size. You go into the store to purchase a pair of shoes, and you have only a few distinct options that you can purchase. You can purchase a size 9. A 9.5, a 10, etc. There are decimals involved, 9.5, 10.5. However, there's not an unlimited number of options. As a result, even though there are decimals, this is discrete in nature because we are limited to just a few countable options. There are not an infinite number of shoe sizes out there. There are many situations where decimals may be present, however, the variable is discrete. I'm going to let you test yourself. The speed of a car traveling down the road, would that be discrete or continuous? Take a second to think about it. In this case, no matter how the speed is measured, with the speedometer inside the car on the dash or by a radar gun, at some point, the instrument doing the measurement must round the value. 42 miles per hour, 42.3. At some point, it must be rounded. Therefore, it is continuous in nature, as it could continue on and on and on. How about the number of candies in this jar? Discrete or continuous? While you may not be excited about counting a large number of candies, it is very possible. They are countable with just a few distinct options. Therefore, this is discrete in nature. Remember, when classifying variables based on discrete or continuous, this only applies to quantitative variables. And if you must round at some point due to the limitations of the instrument measuring the value, it is continuous. If rounding is not necessary, it is discrete.